My great honor to be able to welcome you this afternoon to what is the final concert of the 2022-2023 season. South to the Southwest opened our concert season last fall in September. It was a very early concert for us, and I said, "You're crazy. Nobody's going to be here that early. Everybody's up here like that." Well, we had a great audience. We have a great audience here today, so thank you for being here with us. You are always welcome here at American Lutheran Church, and you are especially welcome to join us for worship. We have services in the summertime at 4 o'clock on Saturday afternoons, and Sunday mornings at 9:30. Great worship experiences with inspirational services, wonderful music, and a community that is just very warm and loving. So please join us if you feel so called to do so. A couple of business matters. Restrooms are out the double doors and to the left if you so need that use. Oh, our favorite devices. Please be respectful of the performers today and your fellow audience members by turning these off or on silent mode so that when you get that also important telephone call in the middle of the performance, you're not disturbing others. So if you do that. But you didn't come here to listen to me talk. You came here to listen to some wonderful music. So without further ado, please help me welcome the Sounds of the Southwest.
Serving the Northwest Valley communities. During our opportunity for giving this afternoon, the Sounds of the Southwest Chorale, founded in 2015, who sing the more traditional works, will take the stage. The chorale will present to you Pepper Toplin's Our Father, Cantata. Next up, however, is Down in the River to Pray, from the movie Oh Brother, Where Art Thou? Then we'll sing The Prayer, which has been recorded by several vocal greats and should sound very familiar to you. This arrangement of the prayer is paired with the hymn Lead Us, Lord, giving this piece inspiring depth. Following that is a brand new song for us this year called To Be Your Song. As you listen, envision the imagery from the text as a sincere expression of faithful service through music.
Our next song, Lift Up Your Heads, is no exception. The text declares that we open up and let the King of Glory come in. Next up is Somewhere in the Silence, a new favorite of ours thanks to composer Joseph Martin and his ability to create such beauty in song. We wrap the segment up with a lively gospel tune, Every Time I Feel the Spirit, a hand clapping, finger snapping, toe tapping kind of song. Feel free to join on in.
Oh, my God.
so much. So you're just going to take a little bit of a break. We're going to have some representatives from the group come out, and this is an opportunity for you to give us some financial support. There's a great financial investment required to offer wonderful music like this, and organizations such as this depend on your generosity. So in a moment, they're going to be coming through with our collection plates, and anything that you can generously give today would be most appreciated. In the meantime,
bring you a cantata that tells the story of the Lord's Prayer in song. It's titled, Our Father, A Journey Through the Lord's Prayer, and was written by our composer friend, Pepper Chapman. It made its debut at Carnegie Hall under Pepper's masterful direction to rave reviews. It's tough to get a good music review in New York, so this tells you that the work is memorable in many ways. We find its message to be so meaningful, being that most of us can recite the Lord's Prayer by memory,
actually hear it in song brings so much more depth, and it's definitely an experience to remember. We hope you as listeners feel the awesome power in these words that we sing. Before we begin, I leave you with a comment of composer Pepper Chapman in preparation for this work. Pepper said, "As I have spent many hours setting this timeless text, I have been continuously struck by its profound power. So potent and succinct, so far-reaching are these few lines. Sometimes, when we pray the prayer, we simply recite it out of habit without grasping its power. I hope this cantata will help you and your listeners connect personally with the prayer so that it will become a significant moment of communion with God. At the end of the reprise, we are not alone. We will ask you to join us in reciting the Lord's Prayer. Ladies and gentlemen,
thank you. healer
and protector. Hallowed is your name. Holy is your name. Here, in these moments, help us experience your name's power as your holiness comes down to fill this place.
Our breath, our health, our food are all supplied by you. Teach us to live in continuous gratitude as we treasure each moment and cherish the precious gift of life.
Our own mistakes, We struggle to forgive ourselves. So as you forgive, show us the power to forgive those who have caused us pain. As you forgive, help us as we try to forgive ourselves.
Thank you. in your presence, let us embody the prayer that you taught us to pray. Our Father, which art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen.
think I'm on the air. Thank you, everyone, for being here. What a great concert. Lots of fun. We always like coming to American Lutheran Church. Before I do the thank yous and sing our final song, there's a presentation I need to make. Not do I just need to make this presentation, but I want to make this presentation. And those of you who are here at American Lutheran worshiping every weekend, you know the value of what I'm about to tell you. You know this person, what it means to you. Usually, the Lutheran Assembly of the Southwest Singers Founders Awards annually at the end of the year. However, occasionally, this award is awarded to those outside of our choir membership, to individuals, couples, or groups within the communities we serve who have made a difference for us on multiple occasions, who have contributed to our success, and who works tirelessly to assist us in our overall purpose. Today, we'd like to recognize a person who helps us organize and coordinate our concerts here at American Lutheran Church. Just one little thing. I'd like to bring up now your organist, your worship coordinator, Dr. James Gerber. James, can you please come up?
Unlike me, I would have been panicking in vain with multiple eye rolls, right?
I don't like change, but James the trooper and doing just whatever we need to do every visit we make to this great church. And for that, James, he is out of the Southwest standing for out. We have something called the Founders Award. It's given by the founder of the choir, myself, and my wife, Leanne, who co-founded this choir. It's called Founders Award. And it's a wonderful thing. I'll pull it out tonight for you. But I would like to now present this to Dr. James Gerber for everything that's happened.
Thank you all so much for being here today. Thank you.